हॅलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू एस क्लास एज्युकेशन. आज आपण पाहणार आहोत 11 स्टँडर्ड सेल डिव्हिजन या चॅप्टरची एक्सरसाइज. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आहे चूज करेक्ट ऑप्शन. त्यामध्ये फर्स्ट आहे द कनेक्टिंग लिंक बिटवीन मियोसिस 1 अँड मियोसिस 2 इज ऑप्शन ए इंटरफेस 1, ऑप्शन बी इंटरफेस 2, ऑप्शन सी इंटरकायनेसिस आणि ऑप्शन डी आहे एनाफेस 1. सो याचं करेक्ट आन्सर आहे ते म्हणजे ऑप्शन सी, दॅट इज इंटरकायनेसिस. सेकंड, सायनॅप्सिस इज पेअरिंग ऑफ ऑप्शन ए एनी टू क्रोमोझोम्स, ऑप्शन बी नॉन होमोलॉगस क्रोमोझोम्स, ऑप्शन सी सिस्टर क्रोमॅटिड्स आणि ऑप्शन डी आहे होमोलॉगस क्रोमोझोम्स. सो याचं करेक्ट आन्सर आहे ते म्हणजे ऑप्शन डी होमोलॉगस क्रोमोझोम्स. थर्ड एमसीक्यू आहे स्पिंडल अपॅरेटस इज फॉर्म्ड ड्युरिंग विच स्टेज ऑफ मायटोसिस, ऑप्शन ए प्रोफेज, ऑप्शन बी मेटाफेज, ऑप्शन सी अनाफेज आणि ऑप्शन डी आहे टेलोफेज. सो याचं करेक्ट आन्सर आहे ऑप्शन बी, दॅट इज मेटाफेज. नेक्स्ट आहे फोर्थ एमसीक्यू, क्रोमोझोम नंबर ऑफ अ सेल इज ऑलमोस्ट डबल्ड अप ड्युरिंग विच फेज. सो फर्स्ट आहे जी 1 फेज, सेकंड आहे एस फेज, थर्ड आहे जी 2 फेज आणि फोर्थ आहे जी 0 फेज. सो याचं करेक्ट आन्सर आहे एस फेज. ई, हाऊ मेनी मियोटिक डिव्हिजन्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ 80 स्पर्म्स, ऑप्शन ए 80, ऑप्शन बी 40, ऑप्शन सी 20 आणि ऑप्शन डी 10. सो याचं करेक्ट आन्सर आहे ऑप्शन सी, दॅट इज 20 मियोटिक डिव्हिजन्स आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ 80 स्पर्म्स. आफ्टर दॅट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एफ, एफ आहे हाऊ मेनी क्रोमॅटिड्स आर प्रेझेंट इन अनाफेज 1 ऑफ मियोसिस 1 ऑफ अ डिप्लॉइड सेल हॅविंग 20 क्रोमोझोम्स. ए आहे 4, बी आहे 6, सी आहे 20 आणि डी आहे 40. सो करेक्ट आन्सर आहे 40 क्रोमॅटिड्स. जी, इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोविंग फेज ऑफ मायटोसिस क्रोमोझोम्स आर अरेंज्ड ॲट इक्वेटोरियल प्लेन, ऑप्शन ए प्रोफेज, ऑप्शन बी मेटाफेज, ऑप्शन सी एनाफेज, ऑप्शन डी टेलोफेज. सो करेक्ट आन्सर इज ऑप्शन बी, दॅट इज मेटाफेज. एच आहे फाइंड करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. ए आहे कंडेन्सेशन ऑफ क्रोमॅटिन मटेरियल ऑकर्स इन प्रोफेज, बी आहे डॉटर क्रोमॅटिड्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन एनाफेज, हे पण राईट आहे, फर्स्ट पण राईट आहे, प्रोफेज मध्येच कंडेन्सेशन होतं आणि टेलोफेज मध्ये डिकंडेन्सेशन होतं. सी आहे डॉटर न्यूक्लियाय आर फॉर्म्ड ऍट मेटाफेज, हे रॉंग आहे, हे आपल्याला पाहायला मिळेल टेलोफेज मध्ये. आणि डी आहे न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन रीअपियर्स इन टेलोफेज, डी राईट आहे. सो इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आहे सी, डॉटर न्यूक्लियाय आर फॉर्म्ड ऍट मेटाफेज. नेक्स्ट आहे हिस्टोन प्रोटीन्स आर सिंथेसाइज्ड ड्युरिंग डॅश फेज, जी 1 फेज, एस फेज, जी 2 फेज की इंटरफेज. सो करेक्ट आन्सर आहे ऑप्शन बी, दॅट इज एस फेज. आफ्टर दॅट सेकंड क्वेश्चन, आन्सर द फॉलोविंग क्वेश्चन्स. ए आहे व्हाइल ऑब्झर्विंग अ स्लाइड स्टुडंट्स ऑब्झर्व्ह मेनी सेल्स विथ न्यूक्लियाय, बट सम ऑफ द न्यूक्लियाय वर बिगर ॲज कम्पेअर टू अदर्स, बट देअर न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रॅन वॉज नॉट सो क्लिअर. टीचर इन्फ्रेड इट ॲज वन ऑफ द फेज इन द सेल डिव्हिजन, विच फेज मे बी इन्फ्रेड बाय टीचर. सो कोणतं फेज असणार ते, दॅट इज दॅट विल बी प्रोफेज. आफ्टर दॅट नेक्स्ट आहे बी, स्टुडंट्स प्रिपेअर्ड अ स्लाइड ऑफ ओनियन रूट टिप अँड देअर वर मेनी सेल्स सीन अंडर मायक्रोस्कोप. There was a cell with two groups of chromosomes at opposite ends of the cell and this cell is in which phase of mitosis. So correct answer will be anaphase. Students were shown some slides of cancerous cells. Teacher made a comment as if there would have been a control at one of its cell cycle phase. There wouldn't be a condition like this. So which phase the teacher was referring to? So she was referring to G1 phase. Next, some Mendelian hybridization experimental results were shown to students. Teacher informed that there are two genes located on the same chromosome. He inquired if they will be ever separated from each other. So, the correct answer for this is first point. The greater the distance and the chance that a crossover can occur between the genes, and the greater the chances of recombination. So the genes are located on chromosomes at a specific distance. Next is, The changes of recombination are less between the genes that are close to each other on the chromosomes. Next one is E. Students were observing a film on paramecium. It underwent a process of reproduction. Teachers said it is due to cell division, but students objected and said that there was no disappearance of nuclear membrane and no spindle formation. How can it be called cell division? Can you clarify? Okay, so the answer is, first, paramecium shows the simplest mode of cell division. Paramecium is a unicellular organism and the division in paramecium occurs by amitosis. In amitosis, nucleus elongates and a constriction appears along its length. This constriction deepens and divides the nucleus in two daughter nuclei followed by the division of cytoplasm. F. In the meiosis, is the meiosis responsible for evolution? Justify your answer. Answer. Meiosis ensures that organisms produced by sexual reproduction contain correct number of chromosomes, right? So meiosis exhibit genetic variation by the process of recombination. Variation increases further and after union of gametes during fertilization, offspring with unique characteristics is produced. So thus, it creates diversity of life and is responsible for evolution. G. Why mitosis and meiosis II are called as homotypic division? So answer. In mitosis, cell divides to form chromosome number and genetic material of daughter cells that remains same as of the parent cell. Second, in meiosis II, two haploid cells formed during first meiotic division and it divides further into four haploid cells. So this division is similar to mitosis. The daughter cells formed in second meiotic division are similar to their parent cells with respect to the chromosome number formed in the meiosis I. And hence, mitosis and meiosis II are called as homotypic division. Okay. Next question, H. Write the significance of mitosis. So answer, mitosis is a type of cell division in which a cell divides to form two similar daughter cells which are identical to it. Therefore, the process of mitosis also maintains the nucleocytoplasmic ratio. As mitosis is equatorial division, the chromosome number is maintained constant. The DNA is also equally distributed. It helps in growth and development of organisms. So this DNA point will be third point and there are total 4 points in this answer. You can also increase it as more points are given in our textbook. Next is enlist different stages of prophase 1. As they have only mentioned that we have to enlist. Enlist means we have to just write the name of the phases. If you want explanation, it is already there in the textbook. You can refer that. Okay. So first ahe leptotin, second ahe zygotin, third ahe pachytin, fourth ahe diplotin, and fifth ahe diagenesis. So these are the 5 stages of prophase 1. Next is draw label diagram and write explanation with the help of suitable diagram and describe the cell cycle. So this is the diagram of the cell cycle. You can refer this diagram, or if it is not visible, then you can refer the diagram which is given in the textbook. It is on the first page itself of the chapter. So let's explain the diagram. First one is the ordered sequence of events that occurred in a cell in preparation for cell division is called a cell cycle. So first we have to at least explain key what do you mean by cell cycle. Interphase. Interphase is the metabolic phase between two successive cell divisions. It is the longest phase of a cell cycle during which the cell is highly active and prepare itself for cell division. The interphase is now subdivided into 3 subphases, that is G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. Next is G1 phase. So what do you mean by G1 phase, or what events take place in the G1 phase? So it is the first growth period or first gap phase. G1 phase begins immediately after cell division. So when the subsequent cell divisions are going on, then after the previous cell division, the first phase is G1 phase. So the RNA, now this RNA means all the other types of RNA, that is mRNA, rRNA and tRNA, synthesizes, protein synthesis and synthesis of membrane take place during this phase. Next is S phase, called as synthesis phase. In this phase, DNA is synthesized or replicated, so the amount of DNA per cell doubles. So this is an important question which can be asked in entrance exams also, that the DNA replication takes place in which of the given phase. A synthesis of histone protein also takes place in this phase. C is G2 phase, also called as second growth phase or second gap phase. Metabolic activities essential for cell division occur during this phase. Apart from this, RNA synthesis also occurs during this phase. Various proteins which are necessary for the cell division are also synthesized in this phase. In animal cell, a daughter pair of centrioles appear near the pre-existing pair. So this was the explanation of cell cycle. If you want, you can further also describe about mitosis. What are the phases of mitosis? What is mitosis? Okay. Next is distinguish between mitosis and meiosis. So first of all, we have to draw the diagram of mitosis and meiosis. So you can check them from here, or also you can refer the diagrams which are given in the textbook. Okay. So let's differentiate mitosis and meiosis. So mitosis is the cell division which takes place in somatic cells and stem cells. Meiosis is the cell division which takes place in germ cells. Daughter cells formed by mitotic division are diploid, and daughter cells formed by meiotic division are haploid. In mitosis, 2 daughter cells are formed, and in meiosis, 4 daughter cells are formed. Next is, in mitosis, nucleus divides only once, and in meiosis, nucleus divides twice, that is, first in meiosis 1 and second in meiosis 2. It plays an important role in growth, repair, healing, and development. It plays important role in the formation of haploid gametes and spores. Okay, done. If you want, you can also take screenshot of this. Let's go ahead. Draw a diagram of metaphase, so you can check out it. Okay. After that, next is, now we have to explain what do you mean by metaphase. So all the chromosomes are arranged at equatorial plane of cells. This is called as metaphase plate. You can also mention points here, like this is the first point, second point, third point, fourth point. Okay, as you wish. So, centromere and sister chromatids become very prominent. Mitotic spindle is fully formed in this phase. Centromere of each chromosome divides into two, each being associated with a chromatid. Okay, if you want to further explain this, you can refer textbook. Next question is that we have to match the columns. Leptotin is matched with the banquet stage. Zygotene is matched with the synapses. Pecatin is matched with the crossing over, and diplotin is matched with the T synapses. Okay. Next one is the given figure correct and why? So first of all, let us check whether the given figure is correct or not. So the given figure is incorrect, as the spindle fiber are not attached to the centromere of the chromosome. So they are just like, they are not passed, they should be passed through this. This is centromere, this is centromere, this is centromere, but they are not passing through the centromere. So this is an issue, or this is the, what we can say, problem in this diagram. So during metaphase, chromosomes are attached to the spindle fiber at the centromere. So why do we say that it is not correct or it is incorrect? Because what happens in the metaphase, the spindle fiber should pass through the centromere, but they are not passing through the centromere. So because of that, we can say like this diagram is incorrect. If an onion has 16 chromosomes in its leaf cell, how many chromosomes will be there in its root cell and pollen grain? So the pollen grain is the chromosome in pollen grain will be 8, as the pollen grain is a haploid cell, right? So it will become half the number of the chromosomes in leaf cell. And next, the leaf cell and the root cell both are diploid cells, both show division by mitotic division, and therefore both will have same number of chromosomes. So the chromosome in root cell will be 16, as root cell is a diploid cell and it show division. It show division by a mitosis process. Next one is identify the given phases of mitosis and label them, label the A and B in the given diagram. So you can clearly say that the spindle fibers are going through the centromere and a metaphasic plate is formed. So this is metaphase, And what is A? So A is basically chromosomes arranged on the metaphase plate. Next is B. So in B, we can see that the chromosomes are divided as chromatids and they are divided apart. So it is anaphase. So chromosomes are moving to the opposite pole. Okay, so this is represented by the B. So in the, chromatids moving to the opposite pole. Okay, this is represented by the B. So in this way, we have completed the exercise of cell division chapter. I hope this video finds useful to you. Please like it, share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching and best of luck for your exams. Bye-bye.